practicing my purpose once again. It is fresh and it is fruitful if I win, but if I lose, ooh, I don't know. I'll be tired, but I'll turn and I will go. Never know until I get there that I'll know. Yes, I'll know. All the children walking home past the factories can see the light that's shining from my window as I write the song for you. And all the cars moving fast along the interstate can see love radiates, illuminating what I know is true. All will be well, it already is, even after you've broken to yourself. All will be well. You can ask me how, but all time will tell. The winter's cold, but the snow still settles gently on the trees. And a mass is still a moment I can seize till I know. And the fight's just as frustrating as hell. All will be well. And all the children walking home past the factories can see the light that's shining from my window as I write this song to you. All the cars moving fast along the interstate can see love radiates, illuminating what I know is true. All will be well, even after all the promises you broke into yourself. All will be well. You can ask me how, but only time will tell. You gotta keep it up and don't give up. Chase your dreams until you find all inside. And all the children walking home past the factories can see the love that's shining from my window as I write this song to you. And all the cars moving fast along the interstate and see the love that radiates, illuminating what I know is true. All is well, even after all the promises you broke into yourself. All is well. You can ask me how, but only time will tell. All will be well, even after all the promises you broke into yourself. All is well. You can ask me how, but only time will tell. You can ask me how, but only time will tell. But you can ask me how, I'll tell.
Morning, Ed. I was thinking about you. I'm very grateful for you. You've been a very important bit. I actually have been working on a book that I was working on when I met you that's actually dedicated to you and to another friend of mine. I can't remember if I ever told you about that, but you were a good road marker. And I love that you showed up in my life. And one of these days, I'm going to sit down and eat food with you and Karen. We're going to play music. I know it. I will hop a plane to Maine when I get time if we don't figure it out some other way. It's got to happen. So, Kenika update.
Kenika was over at sundown yesterday. That is the way. It always starts on January 2nd at sunrise and goes to Martin Luther King evening then it's all put to rest. Back in the heyday of my time as a writer, we would use that time to get together and celebrate. I had a party down here when I turned 50 and I recorded a live album with my buddy Kevin Elmore. And then had a party up in Bellevue with my buddy John, who's gone now, but that's okay, he's in my heart even still. And we'd get together during Kenika season, sometimes at conventions with other writers. I remember this one time some dude just kissed me, and then we became friends, even though I don't really swing that way at all. But he had read a flyer somewhere that said, "Hey, birthday boy is turning 40, and you should kiss him real good." So he did. Kenika, ghost of Kenika past. Oh, I don't know about more Kenika. Oh, I was kidnapped by pirates one Kenika. Three of them. They were cute. So Kenika used to be a much... Hey, hi, Brenda. Brenda's been to some Kenikas. I think you might have been at the RustyCon Kenika party. But anyway. Oh, yeah. And now... I decided to have a quiet Kenika by myself, out at the coast making friends and doing my dance. So I went out there with my gear and I sent a bunch of notes, and I found myself a place to play some songs. For my birthday dinner, it was pretty good. Prime rib rare, baked potato with everything on it, salad with blue cheese dressing, and then after my show, after my last set, I had some of the best clam chowder I've ever had. Some of the weirdest drinks I ever drank. This one thing's called a raspberry Scooby-Doo. They call it a Daffy, or a raspberry Scooby Snack. I don't know. But I had a good birthday. Spent some time with my buddy Ken. And I met up with some writers that I never see. Like, hey, Brenda, I had lunch with Stephen York and Christina York in Lincoln City, where we all used to meet and hang. And I picked up three magazines all within a year and a half of my birthday. And they were old, and they smelled old. Yellow paper, old. I guess that's what I am at 55. Looked at some stories from Edmund Hamilton and some other classic writers. Oh, they were great. We had a good time. It was nice. There'll be more get-togethers, I'm sure, because I have been scouting that whole area within about 2 hours of me. Because it's an easy trip to go make some music, see some friends. Some oysters in the months with an R. I guess that's the way that eaten oysters are. Only in months with R. So never May or June or July or August. No oysters then. Hey, Jeannie, cousin Jeannie, good to see you. So I'm on holiday because it's Martin Luther King Day and no work. So, kids coming soon. They'll send me a note when they wake up and they're ready. Mm-hmm. But yeah, good birthday. Introspective birthday. Just, you know, still in that process of that gambler, right? You know, you gotta know. Know and fool. Know and walk. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time to count when the deal's done. One of the wisest songs I ever heard, but you know, I think that
think the thing is, we put our truth in our art. We bury it there. And then other people see it when they need to see it, or when they can see it, when they get out of their way enough to see it. And so a song or a movie or a story, like, I watched my life change. If I go back now and trace it, now that I know what I know about how humans create their experience of life, I can go back and see that trail of where songs and stories hit me with some truth that I needed in that moment, that I was able to receive in that moment. I can also now look back and see all the times when somebody walked up to me and I was running around screaming about how on fire I was, and they had that big bucket of water and they were right there so sweetly and so kindly offering it. And I said, get that away. I'm glad you found something that worked for you, but get that water away from me. I'm on a different kind of fire here. And now I understand that that was one of the things I did to keep myself sick, to keep myself lost and stuck in a low level of understanding. So, but I don't even know why I chased that little rabbit hole, but I had a reason I was going. So anyway, I'm a little introspective because as I learning how to let go of things, I tend to be very sentimental, and I had some programming to hang on to certain beliefs and ideas and people. And my life has gotten better the more I've learned to let go of the things that I thought I could not let go of, and to lay hold of things. I laid hold of things I never imagined possible. So I think that the human potential is pretty awesome if we're willing to look, the right direction. A lot of us get caught up in the what they call the illusory nature of life. Makes sense. We're wired for fitness, but we're fueled by belief. And our belief is that our thoughts and feelings are telling us the truth. We don't understand that our thoughts and feelings are generated through a perceptive system that has been honed over billions of years. And so our thoughts, our system of thoughts, which turn into beliefs if we let them, so, you know, you do that. Yeah, exactly, right? I know, Jeannie, I know you get what I'm talking about. And yeah, there's just something about grace and about accepting. And I think that, now as one through my journal, that's not really a journal. I keep my book. I have that book for, like, I want to sketch down lyrics and I want to sketch down my to-do lists, things like that. And so I found in there, I found a little thing. I was working on some lyrics and it's this tiny little thing in the corner. It said, love equals acceptance. And love is a buzzword that we use for lots of things. But I think acceptance is a good word around that. And then it said, truth equals reality. You know, it's not, my reality is my truth, right? And then the other was something that, I don't know, the next one was understanding. Now I can't remember, and I don't know where I left the book, but it was fun to run across that while I was out having my time. Just be here now. Stand with me. Place your hand with mine upon the bark of this redwood tree. Take a breath, let it go. That space between holds all the peace you'll ever need to know. Follow that quiet feeling down. And darlings, lay with me on this blanket in the wind while it whispers to the sea. Hold my hand, look toward home, 'cause when you meet my eyes like that, don't you know you meet my soul?
follow. Heartbeat pounding down. Darling, be here now. And when the storm clouds fill your eyes, and they overtake your smile, I know that you'll realize, oh, in just a little while, that every single question ever asked about the why or how is simply answered. Be here now. Just be here now.
In the approximate moment.
Be here. Here now, watch with me, harvest moon is rising, yonder past that old oak tree, stand and shout, sing and dance, life's upon you, you're alive, every now is another chance. Another chance. Follow those freedom feelings down. And darlings, be here now. Follow those freedom feelings down. And darlings, be here now.
I do love that song. Let's say, well, you know, again, we put our truth in a song, and I could take that song and talk for a year about the different nuances of what I'm trying to point to. But I'm actually singing to people who I think already get that. So. This song is a birthday song. It pops up a lot for me these days.
I've been really thinking about my lifetime. All the things I've done and how it's been. I can't help believing in my own mind. You know I'm gonna hate to see it end. I've seen a lot of sunshine, and I have slept out in the rain. Spent a night or two on my own. Well, I've known some lady's pleasures, and I had myself some friends. Spent a night or two in my own home. And I have to say now, it's been a good life all in all. It's really fine to have the chance to hang around, to lie there by the fire and watch the evening tire. All my friends and my oldie sitting past the pipe around. Talk of poems and prayers and promises and things that we believe in. How sweet it is to love someone, how right it is to care, and how long it's been since yesterday. What about tomorrow? What about our dreams and all the memories we share? They pass so quickly now, the nights are seldom long. Time around me whispers when it's cold,
these changes do not frighten me. Still I have to smile. Turns me on to think of growing. But though this life's been good to me, there's still so much to do. So many things my mind has never known. I'd like to raise my family, and I'd like to sail away, dance across the mountains on the moon. And I have to say it now, it's been a good life all in all. It's really fine to have the chance to hang around and to lie there by the fire and watch the evening tire while all my friends and my homie sit and watch the sun go down after we've had some Karen's pie. Won't that be great? And talk poems and prayers and promises, things that we believe in. How sweet it is to love someone, how right it is to care, and how long it's been since yesterday. Oh, what about tomorrow? What about our dreams and all the memories we share? I used to love this song when I was a kid, but I didn't understand it at all. Now, here at 55, and all my birthdays really since about 50, I get it. I found the truth that he buried in the song. So, I was talking, I've been talking a lot about how, you know, December's just been kind of a weird month because my amygdala has been more active, and it activates in my sleep through dreams. So that's been a little crazy, but it's been, I'm fine. I'm doing fine right now. And I have been really. Good morning, Jacqueline. This is one of my own songs that I didn't understand for 15 years. I didn't know who I had written it for. A line in it that I'm held fast by love at last in you, and I never knew who it was, and I never gave the song a title. And then one day I was singing the song and I realized the title, because I knew who the song was about. It was about me. And so I called it Love Song to My Future Self, because once I hit the point in the journey, I had an aha moment. And in that aha moment, I knew that, okay, I've become the guy that's giving me the love I need. It's pretty interesting how that all can work. But here's how the song, listen to the song, listen to these lyrics. Because, oh, there's soup. It's a lot of soupy lyrics. I want to talk about lines. I'm talking about playing the role that you're supposed to play. Talk about crimes, talk about growing up in a family full of many things that could have had everybody put in jail on felonies, including sexual abuse and physical abuse. Clowns, becoming hysterically funny and using humor as a coping device. Anyway, that's some of it, but here you go. Lines and crimes and clowns and me. All hanging from this Judas tree, where betrayers hang themselves. I try to shake this thorny ground, pull out those nails and come on down. But I'm held fast by someone else's past and pain. Someone else's past and pain. My parents, my family. Generational abuse and trauma. Signs and times and harmony. Pentecostalism and Simon and Garfunkel. Scars and harder parts of me. They are the soup that saves my soul. The shattered mirror that cuts me whole. And I'm held.
fast by love at last. By love at last. And I don't know, but I've been told that heaven's streets are paved with gold. But it seems more like blood to me. Baby, that's a mystery. And I'm held fast by love at last. By love at last.
Love song to my future self, circa 2005 or 6. But all of it buried across the landscape of my stories. A lot of my short fiction, if you've not read it, is, oh, sweet, you sweet, sweet cousin. It's a music, we put our truth in the music, and then it can go out, and it resonates with the truth inside of other people, the reality, the ground that they all, we all stand on. So that's how, it is how it's supposed to go. Now I'm doing a thing in February in Astoria called Making Friends with the Monsters Underneath Your Bed. Hey, Lee Taylor, I wish I had milk. I don't. I have classic lemonade and not much of that left. Might have some coffee. Anyway, I'm doing a thing up there. I'm singing all of my original stuff. And I'm talking about my relationship with the complex PTSD, which is all it is just a label we create for a whole bunch of ways of crystallized thinking that get crunchy and people they get lost and stuck inside of themselves, right? So I'm going to go do this music, this song, a bunch of other songs, about 8 or 9, 10 songs. Plus I'm reading a short story of mine that I wrote probably 20 years ago, called The Monsters Underneath His Bed, about a man who's troubled and learns to make friends with the monsters under his bed, and to accept and embrace. I used to tell people, we got to make friends with the monsters under our bed to deal, because we put the monsters under our bed to protect us from the monsters our parents put in the closet. But anyway, I'll be up there in Astoria doing my dance in February. So, and then afterwards, for people who want to do a deeper dive kind of into the singer-songwriter storytelling aspects or the PTSD aspects, I'm going to do a coffee clatch the next day, an AMA coffee clatch. So that should be fun. There's a store up there sponsoring this. She really cares about the cause, so that should be a good thing. Like to think we can find our way back to somewhere in time and space, not far from here, drive our way straight through, headlights burning up the highway, moonbeam clouds in our rearview mirror. Wide open starshine in a Guthrie skyway. Love can be no clearer. Love can be no clearer. Because love is as love does. Just you and me. Driving here. Searching for something we can steer into. Oh, say, can you see? They're up. Head, dawn's early shining bright upon you. Wind is whipping sand across the highway. The past is laughing in my rearview mirror. Pink contrails in a Pan Am skyway. Home can be no nearer.
rain is gone, rain is gone. I can see clearly now, rain. I can see clearly now, the rain is gone, the rain is gone. I have been one acquainted with the night. I have walked out in rain and back in rain. I have outwalked the farthest city light. I have looked down the saddest city lane. Passed by the watchman on his beat. Drop my eyes, unwilling to explain. Stood still and stopped the fast sound of feet. Went far away an interrupted cry. Came over houses from another street. Would not call me back or say goodbye. Further still at an unearthly height. One luminary clock against the sky proclaimed the time was neither wrong nor right. I have been one acquainted with the night. I have been one acquainted with the night.
Good morning, Beth. Welcome to the early Monday Martin Luther King Show. No work. No kids for another hour or so. I'm all caffeinated and showered and ready. Gonna go do some grocery shopping soon. Not much grocery shopping. Enough to get tacos, I think. I'm gonna make tacos today. We'll see. Huh. Well. Trying to think what I might want to do now. Hello, Stacy. Firing bullets to the sky. Your love is like a soldier, loyal till you die. I've been putting out for a long, long time. Been putting out fires for all of my life. Everybody wants the they don't want to get burned. Today is our turn. Days like these
people like us, they don't need that much. Just someone who starts the spark in our bonfire hearts. Oh, oh. Looks you in the eye. I've been looking at you for a long, long time, and trying to break through, trying to blow your mind. Everybody wants the flame, they don't want to get burned. Today is our turn. Days like these lead to nights like this, lead to love like ours. Thanks, Lee. You light the spark in our bonfire heart. That's why I do it. Spend time with my people that make music. People like us, we don't need that much. Just someone who starts the spark in our bonfire heart.
This is a James Blunt song, actually. And his, the video to this song is beautiful. He's living the dream, riding a motorcycle across Montana and Idaho, I think. And he stops and plays music at a wedding and people dance. It's beautiful. Good stuff. But yeah, I love doing this, and I get up to do this myself, right? I remember. Yep. Oh, you are always welcome. And Jeannie, like I've said, you and I can chat, I mean, anytime. If we wanted to set up like weekly or monthly cousin time, I would be so down for that. And we can even talk about some of this stuff, right? Hey, Virginia. Howdy, good morning. So yeah, I'm getting ready. I'm just wrapping up. I'm getting ready to be done because I'm getting, because I've been playing a bit here. I'm going to do one more and then I'm going to call it good. But I had Kenika was a glorious time. And, I had a good, it was a good trip. Oh, I won enough money on Thursday night to pay for most of my trip because I never play video poker. But I decided birthday, Kenika weekend was going to be a weekend of trying stuff. So I did that. Well, let's set something up because it'd be super easy for me to do. I have all the time in the world. You and I could easily grab an hour on Zoom or chat here or whatever. It'd be good. I think it'd be good for me. I'm reestablishing contact with cousins on my dad's side of the family too, which has been really awesome back in Idaho. Oh, I'll be out there sometime in February. It's a pretty specialized thing. As soon as I know all of the details, I'll put it up on Facebook. I'm looking though, Lee, I'm looking to come play. I'm going to try and get a show at the Village Inn Lounge and bring the CD and sell it. And that'd be a thing that I would love to see you come out and maybe join me for a song or two if you're up for it. Well, I love you, Jeannie. I'm going to do one more song. I'm going to call good. Because I do have to go to Winco and get taco fixings and get ready for the ladies to come home to me. I have missed them. I haven't seen them since Thursday morning. Here we go. I'll do this one. Do my hug song. It's my hug to all of you. It's called A Lullaby for the Wounded. It's been a long, hard day. Why don't you get some rest? You ran a good, hard race. I know you did your best.
very best. And sometimes, you know, the best gifts we get come wrapped in pain. No matter,
oh wait, that's the wrong line.
Sometimes, you know, second place is not that bad. No matter how it goes, what matters most is that you had.
Oh, I'd love to do that. I was ready to do it this summer, but we just didn't make it come together.
It's been a long, hard day. I see you scraped your knee somewhere on the lake. Now you'll have a scar like me. Sometimes, you know, the best gifts we get come wrapped in pain.
Which is weird, it's ironic, but it's true.
No matter how far you go, where you've been is still the same. It's been a long, hard day. Tomorrow's coming soon. It's just a sleep away. Bright and shiny and brand new. And sometimes, you know, the reasons are a mystery. And that's the way it goes. And sometimes, it's okay. It has to be okay to let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. There will be an answer, let it be.
All right, y'all. Hope you have a fantastic Monday. And then again, thank you all of you who extended birthday wishes. Thank you, thank you. Appreciate it. I've tried to go through and heart as many as I could. They show up in all the strange places, like comments on past posts and things. So I'll try. But off I go. Hope you have a fantastic day. Yes, taco time with the girls. You bet. I'll talk to you all soon.